Hi everyone, today we'll discuss gear tooth vernier caliper and then we'll move towards analytical method of finding out gear tooth thickness and depth. So friends, we know that there are many instruments those can be used in gear measurements, but it is not possible for a single instrument to measure all the parameters of gear terminology. So there are certain instruments those we can use to measure gear tooth thickness. Few instruments can be used in order to measure piece circle diameter. For functional checking, there are several other instruments. So this gear tooth vernier caliper is the simplest instrument among all the instruments. It consists of two vernier calipers. We have seen how to handle vernier calipers. It is very simple instrument to take the reading, to measure the reading. So here one vernier caliper is placed horizontally in order to measure thickness of a tooth, and one vernier caliper is placed vertically in order to measure depth of a tooth. Construction, it is very simple. It is, see, the tooth profile is placed in this way, in between these two jaws. Right side jaw, which is a movable jaw, and left side jaw, it is a fixed jaw. So you will find one more jaw is there, which is in between these two jaws, and that jaw is movable jaw, this jaw. This is a vertical movable jaw, and as this is placed or as this is held in between these two jaws, it can be called as tongue of this instrument. When this tongue is placed on this top surface of a tooth, these two jaws are in correct position to measure thickness of a tooth. Means to measure thickness of a tooth, to set the position of these two jaws, we need to place this tongue on the top portion of a tooth. So I have drawn separate tooth profile. So this is the required tooth profile. Then I have taken center of the gear. See, this OA and OB represents radius of a piece circle. See, this is the piece circle. We need to find out thickness of a tooth, which is indicated with the notation small t, and then we have to find out depth of a tooth, which is indicated with the help of small d. See, distance AB indicates caudal thickness of a tooth, which is indicated here, and this small d indicates depth of a tooth till caudal thickness, means the distance between this point C and top of the tooth indicates depth. There is a difference between addendum and depth. See, addendum is the distance between this E to top of the tooth. This distance is nothing but addendum, and this distance is nothing but depth of a tooth. So now we will derive two formulas, one to find out tooth thickness and one to find out tooth depth. So we will start with tooth thickness. So tooth thickness T is nothing but this distance AB, this caudal thickness. So T is equal to AB. So to find out AB, you have to find out CB or AC, because these are evenly spaced. That means AC is equal to CB. So I will consider this triangle COB in order to find out CB. Triangle COB. So to find out CB, see, I have this distance. This distance is radius of the piece circle. So to find out CB, I need to find out this angle first. This is a phi, pressure angle, that we have seen in our previous lecture. So to find out this phi, we will consider a concept of circular pitch. So we have seen what is circular pitch. I will consider one more tooth profile. We know that what is circular pitch. See, consider this is a piece circle. So it is the distance between two points. One point, a point on piece circle to the corresponding point on next tooth. That means a distance between a point on one tooth to the corresponding point on next tooth. So this distance is nothing but circular pitch. So I know that how to find out angle included by these two radii. See, these are the two radii of piece circle. So we know that to find out the angle included by these two lines, which is equal to total angle 360 divided by number of teeth. Number of teeth is T. So I will get this angle. So now we know that this tooth thickness is equal to this thickness, or this part, right? this is equal to this. So we can, I can evenly divide this into four parts. See, this will be even part, then this point and this point. So I can divide this complete angle into four parts, and that is the reason that I will get the value of this. To find out theta, I will consider sine theta. Sine theta, which is equal to sine 360 by t. I have to divide this by 4. So I will get this angle I am interested in. So 360 divided by 4, it will be 90 degrees by t, which is equal to sine theta. Sine theta is equal to front side divided by hypotenuse, front side CB. So CB divided by OB. So sine 90 degrees by t, which is equal to CB. CB is unknown. OB. OB is the radius of this circle. So you can write here as R. So CB is equal to R into sine 90 degrees by t. Now one more formula that we know is module M. So M is equal to pitch circle diameter D divided by number of teeth. So this implies that D is equal to MT. We can again write in this form. D is nothing but 2R, which is equal to MT. So R is equal to MT by 2. So I can substitute this value in this formula. So I'll get the formula in the form of module. So CB is equal to, substitute the value of R, MT by 2, MT by 2 sine 90 degrees by T. CB. Now I have to find out a formula for T thickness, which is AB and which is nothing but 2CB. So thickness is equal to 2CB, which is equal to, this 2 will get cancelled. So MT sine 90 degrees by T. So this is the formula that I can use to find out thickness of a tooth if I know module and number of teeth. Now we'll derive a formula for depth of a tooth D. So how will I get this distance D? D is equal to total distance OD minus OC. So that I will get this distance OC. Now OD is equal to C. OD you can again write in this form, OE plus, because OE, I know the OE, it is a radius of pitch circle, plus ED, you can call this as addendum. That means OE is nothing but R plus A. A is addendum. So now to find out OC. To find out OC, I have to consider a triangle COB. To find out OC, I will consider this angle cos of phi. Cos of phi is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So OC divided by OB. OC is unknown. OB I know, OB is the radius of pitch circle R. So this implies that OC is equal to R cos phi. I need to keep in mind one more formula to find out addendum. So addendum, or I can simply write A is equal to 1 upon diametrical pitch. In first lecture we have seen what is diametrical pitch. So diametrical pitch is nothing but number of teeth divided by D. which is equal to d by t, and d by t is nothing but module m. So now we can substitute the value of a in this formula, final formula. Substitute all this value, value of OD in this equation, value of OC in this equation, and value of A in this equation. So we will get the formula D is equal to OD R plus A or R plus M, because A is equal to M. Then minus OC, OC is equal to R cos phi. R cos phi. So we know that in terms of m, I have find out the value of r, which is pi, sorry, which is mt by 2 plus m minus mt by 2 cos of phi. I can simplify this equation. So m will be a common factor, m into bracket 1 plus, in these two terms we can take a common factor t by 2, t by 2 into bracket 1 minus cos phi, bracket complete. So this is the formula which can be used to find out depth of a tooth. In this way, analytically also we can find out the thickness of a tooth and depth of a tooth, and by using this instrument also we can find out both these parameters and we can just compare the values. See, as far as the accuracy is concerned, accuracy of this instrument is limited to its least count. Its least count may be 0.01, 0.02, it depends on how many number of divisions are there on main scale and vernier scale. So thank you very much for watching this video. See you in my next lecture. Bye bye.